Good morning, amazing artists. I hope you're doing great. And either you joined me in class this week or you couldn't join me, and so you're catching up with this video. If you join me in class, you're welcome to watch the video and catch up on what we learned, or you can just upload your assignment on Seesaw. So this week in class, we are talking about the artist's identity. We started thinking about that last week, right? We said we're going to be introducing this first week the artist Jean-Michel Basquiat. Jean-Michel Basquiat is a very, very famous artist. And we are going to be thinking about what style the artist used. What was the ideas behind their art? What maybe are some symbols that you see repeated in the art? What materials did the artist use? And why did the artist choose to make art, do you think? These are all things that we can think about when we think about the artist identity. That means, who is the artist? You all have your own identity too, as a person and as an artist. It's the part that makes you your unique artist, right? Super important. So we're gonna get started on that in a minute. I don't have my special tool today, but we'll just do it by ourselves. We'll say our affirmation. My heart is open. My ideas matter. I'm an amazing artist and I am loved. Okay, so for this project today, if you have your sketchbook, great, or you can grab some paper, or you can grab an old cereal box, whatever kind of paper you might be able to use. And then you can use markers or crayons or paint or colored pencils, whatever you prefer. So go grab those things and come back and we'll get started looking at the art of Jean-Michel Basquiat. All right, I hope you got your materials. I'm gonna share my screen and I'm gonna share with you a book. And I'm not gonna read the story today. The story is an amazing poem by an amazing poet named Maya Angelou. But today we're gonna focus on the illustrations, the pictures. And these illustrations are the actual artworks of Jean-Michel Basquiat. So I want you to notice, what do you see? What repeated themes do you see? What kind of energy do you feel in the artwork? Let's take a look. Some of you might recognize this book. We did read it a couple years ago, and some of you might have been a little bit younger. It's called Life Doesn't Frighten Me. But we're really using it today to look at the artwork. So let's check it out. Notice the crown. You might see a crown in a lot of his work. The body, we'll talk a little bit later. He uses the body in a lot of his work too. Sometimes you might see bones or this mouth repeated or the eyes. Skeleton, this one. Notice again, the crown right on top of the dragon or the dinosaur. Again, two more crowns in that same kind of mouth and face and eyes. There's a lot of movement too in these pictures. If you notice, he presses hard with his materials when he's drawing. To me, I can see a lot of expression or feeling in his art. This is about Maya Angelou, the poet, and this is the artist, Jean-Michel Basquiat. All right, so when I said he expresses a lot of feelings, see, artists do art for all different reasons. Sometimes they create art because they want to create a pretty picture. Sometimes they create art because they're doing a portrait or drawing of somebody. Sometimes they use art to really express what they feel inside. So Jean-Michel Basquiat, he started doing art from the time he was a little boy, 4 years old. He loved to make art. was always coloring on anything he could get his hands on. And when he was little, he was playing outside and he got hit by a car and he had to lay in bed for a long time to heal. And his mom bought him a copy of a book called Grey's Anatomy. It was a book that had pictures of a lot of body parts. And you notice that he uses a lot of body parts in his work. And then when he got a little bit older, his mom got sick. She had some problems, mental problems, and she had to go to a hospital and stay there. And Basquiat was sad about that. He stayed with his dad. And later he left high school to go to New York City and pursue doing his own art in the city. And he became a very, very well-known artist, and he still got to share his work with his mom. And he became one of the most famous artists of our time. You might notice seeing some art on clothing or hip-hop albums or different things where you still might see Basquiat's art in many different places because his work is very, very famous. So when we were talking about his work, I said he uses a lot of emotion in his work. He uses a lot of movement, right? He presses hard and he expresses himself. And those emotions can be expressed in different feelings. Like he might express anger and humor, something funny at the same time. Or maybe something happy and sad. Or this book is about things that maybe frighten us. So you can use your artwork to express your feelings. We talked a little bit about that last week. So this week, I would like you to try expressing yourself in the style of Basquiat. So think about, what did you notice from the story, from the pictures in the story? And how could you take the feelings that you feel inside and express them on your paper? If you feel angry, you might have to take your crayon and press really, really hard if that's how you feel. Or what might sadness look like? Maybe it's the colors you use. What would happy and sad at the same time be? I don't know how you feel. You get to express how you feel on your paper. So I hope that you've enjoyed learning a little bit about Basquiat, and I'm excited to see your ideas of how to create your own feelings using his style. Because when we learn about other artists, we also develop ourselves as artists. So when you get finished, upload your picture onto Seesaw, and then be sure, like always, when you have your art, that you tuck it inside your sketchbook or your art folder and you keep it in one place, because we're actually going to be working on these again next week. We're going to work on this project for 2 weeks and really, really get into it. So have fun with it and notice what you feel and try to get it out on the paper. All right. Remember, try your best, never give up, and you are so loved. See you later, alligators.